Hey guys, it's Muzmi. Welcome to another in-depth Cold War camo guide. Today we're going to be covering the diamond shotguns. Now, these are something that have actually been requested a lot more than I thought they would be. A lot of you guys have been struggling with some elements of the diamond shotgun grind, so I thought, you know what? Let's go. Let's make this video. So here I am, making the diamond shotgun video. As with all of my camo guides in Cold War, I make sure that everything I'm saying is researched, it's factually correct, and it is the best advice you can possibly be getting. So you know that when you're watching this video, absolutely everything that I say will be the best advice you can possibly find on YouTube for the camo challenge guide. If this video helps you, then I've got absolutely loads of other camo guides for some of the hardest weapons in Cold War and everything else in between. So make sure to go check out this playlist in the top right corner of your screen if you want the best help you can find on YouTube for Cold War camo guides. Of course, if you want to keep up to date with my content and any future guides that I put out, make sure to hit that subscribe button and even turn on notifications if you want to. Anyway, I think it's time to get started with the tips, so let's begin with the class setup to be using on the shotguns for the diamond camo grind. And right here, we have got the best general class setup that you can be using on the shotguns in Cold War. So to start with, we've got Perk Greed. None of the other wildcards really help you at all here. This is by far the best one for the shotguns. Perks are pretty much down to personal preference, but obviously, the ones that I've been using are Tactical Mask, Flat Jacket, Scavenger, Gearhead, Ninja, and Ghost. These are just, in my opinion, the best perks pretty much in the game. And then in the Tactical, running the Stim Shot, Lethal, Semtex, and Field Upgrade is the Field Mic. As for the primary weapon, this really doesn't matter. You're not going to be using it at all if you're just going for the shotgun, so use whatever you want. If you're leveling something up, put that there if you want to, but you're just going to be focusing on the shotgun, so doesn't matter what the primary is. So that's the overall class setup covered. Going into the attachments on the Gallo SA-12 in this case, like I said though, the attachments do basically work for any of the shotguns, just use the equivalent ones. And in the muzzle, I've just been using the Duckbill Choke. It gives you 50% wider pellet spread, and this really just helps you at those kind of close ranges where obviously you're going to be using the shotgun, and it's just a really good attachment that has no cons with it, one that I really do enjoy using. Then in the barrel, we've got the 24.8 inch Task Force. Now this barrel is, yes, it does reduce the effective damage range by quite a bit, but the massive pro to this one is the 52% damage. That's obviously a big number, and let me just show you something. With this 52% increased damage, you're doing 164 damage at maximum damage, so within that 5-meter range. This means because an enemy only has 150 hit points, you're able to one-shot them. Without this attachment, we'll just hover over something else, you can't one-shot enemies at all with this shotgun. However, when you put that task force on, you're able to do so. So that is a really important attachment on this gun. Then in the magazine, we're using the Stanag 12-round tube mag. This obviously increases your magazine size massively, which is really important on the Gallo. You want to be able to absolutely blast every enemy you see. Then in the handle, airborne elastic wrap. Best attachment in the game, pretty much. There's no contest here, so I'll move straight onto the stock. We're using the Marathon stock. This is a great attachment on the shotguns, giving you 4% sprinting move speed, 10% shooting move speed, and 25% sprint to fire time, and 10% aim walking move speed. It's really good. You do lose some hip fire accuracy, but that's not really that bad on a shotgun. So this is the overall class setup you should be using on the shotgun, as you can see, all the lovely attachments there. And like I said, this is the best general setup for shotguns. If there's any adjustments that need to be made for specific challenges, I will tell you when we get to them. But as a start, this is what you want to be using. As for game modes, this is an important thing to cover as well. All of the challenges for the shotguns can be done relatively easily in core, but if you don't mind playing hardcore, then it will speed up the camo grind just a little bit. And the best modes for the shotgun camo challenges, and to be honest, most of the camo challenges, are 6v6 face-off, Nuketown 24/7, and 12v12 mosh pit. These playlists are all just as viable as each other, and are available in both core and hardcore, which is absolutely ideal. So literally stick to those playlists whilst you're getting diamond shotguns done, and you'll be absolutely golden. So now that we've covered the best class setup for the shotguns and the best game modes to be playing, let's move over to the camo challenge tips. Unlocked at level 1 are the spray challenges. For these, you simply have to get 200 eliminations with your chosen shotgun. This challenge is so easy, it's going to get done whilst you're just leveling the gun up pretty much, so we don't even need to cover it. So we'll move straight on to the next challenge, which is the stripes, which are unlocked at level 5. In order to unlock the stripes camos, you must get 50 total headshots with the Gallo SA-12 in multiplayer. Again, this is a pretty simple challenge, especially if you're playing hardcore, you get so many headshots. Generally, this will also be done by the time you're leveled, or at least by the time you're finishing up the other camo challenges. If you are struggling with this, just if there's any like AFK players, or if you manage to sneak up behind someone, just make sure you take the opportunities to get those headshots. Take your time before taking the shot and you'll be absolutely fine. And I mean, we are absolutely speeding through this. That's headshots covered. We'll move on to the next one, which is classic, unlocked at level 10. And now this is For some people, quite a hard challenge, and it is to get 5 killstreaks 20 times with all kills coming from the Gallo or whatever shotgun you're using in multiplayer. So I do understand why some people struggle with this challenge, because it can be quite tricky depending on kind of if you're playing in the right playlist, the right mode. They really do make a big difference, and I did most of my shotgun work in hardcore, and this challenge was okay in hardcore, but if I had a few left to get, I did then jump over to core because I just prefer core as a whole, and I find it is obviously much easier to stay alive. You've got those stim shots that really help you out. So if you do get into a bit of a tricky situation on like 3 or 4 kills, you can sometimes escape it, whereas hardcore, 1 bullet and you're dead. It's really not very forgiving at all. So I guess that's probably my first main tip for getting these 5 kill streaks, the bloodthirsty medals, is do it in core. It's just much more forgiving there, and you'll have a much easier time staying alive. My next main tip for this challenge is basically just don't overthink it whilst you're trying to get this done. A lot of the 5 kill streaks I get when using shotguns is just when I'm kind of messing around, I'm just playing normally, I'm really not thinking about it. So whatever your normal playstyle is when you're using close range weapons like SMGs or obviously shotguns, just stick to that, just play, have fun, and you will probably get this challenge done without even realizing it. And if that's not quite enough for you, if you're still struggling with this challenge, then my next final tip for this one would be when you're approaching a 5 kill streak, so say you're on 3 kills, maybe even 4 kills, just back off a bit, play a bit more passive and try and get a cheesy kill on someone. Maybe camp a bit, sit in a corner, be that guy. It doesn't matter, we're not playing for honor or anything ridiculous like that. We're just here to get camo challenges done. So if you are on 3 or 4 kills, just back off, wait for an enemy to come by, maybe even camp a field mic. Just do whatever you have to do in order to get that last 1 or 2 kills. And honestly, if anyone calls you a camper, whatever, who cares? You're playing the game how you want to play the game. You're here to get camo challenges done. Who cares? Just because you killed them in a way that they didn't agree with, that's not your problem. That's their problem. If they want to get angry about it, that's fine by me. And I think that is pretty much all the advice I can give for getting 5 kill streaks realistically. So hopefully that helps you with this challenge, and we'll move on to the next one, which is the geometric challenges, and these are to get 50 long shot medals with the Gallo SA-12 in multiplayer. This challenge probably sounds quite hard, getting long shots with a shotgun. But in Cold War, and I think many other CODs as well in the past, different weapon classes have different long shot ranges. So I'll show you right now what the shotgun long shot range is. So we will jump out of the class setup, go into the barracks, combat record, multiplayer, find a shotgun. Where is one? There we go, the Gallo, the one we were just looking at. Then look over here in the top right corner and you can see the long shot range, 14 meters plus. All you have to do is kill an enemy who is over 14 meters away, and that's a long shot, and that is absolutely nothing. I'll show you right now an in-game example of how far 14 meters is, and as you can see, barely any distance at all. It's so easy to get, and like I said when I was talking about the class setup, you can do this quite easily in core, but for this challenge in particular, for long shots, it's so easy in hardcore, because you are able to easily one-shot enemies from like 20, 25, maybe even 30 meters with the shotguns. And yeah, like, it's just so easy, especially with the Gallo and the Street Sweeper, because they are semi or full automatic. You can just mow down the enemies in hardcore. It's so much fun using those shotguns in hardcore. Less so with the Hauer, because again, it's a pump action shotgun, so it is a bit harder to use. But even still, definitely go into hardcore to get the long shots done, because it's by far the quickest place to get this challenge done. And that's all there really is to getting long shots with shotguns. Just go into hardcore if you want a real easy time with this one. I would say as soon as you unlock this challenge at, what is it, 5, 10, 15. As soon as you unlock this challenge at level 15 on the shotguns, jump into hardcore, smash this challenge out, then go straight back into core, because I personally cannot stand hardcore, but when it's the quickest way of getting a camo challenge done, I will go there. And that covers long shots, so now we'll move on to Flora, which are unlocked at level 20. And to get this camo challenge done, you have to kill 75 enemies detected, stunned, or blinded by your score streaks, equipment, or field upgrades in multiplayer. 75 detected enemies might sound like quite a bit, but it's really not. Basically, all you want to do is run UAV and HARP as your score streaks, whatever you want in the middle. No other score streaks really help you that much with this challenge. And then you want to be running a field mic as your field upgrade, and you are good to go. I would say probably, obviously depending on how good you are, but I would say about 80 to 90% of your detected kills are going to come from your UAV usage and your field mic usage. UAVs are obviously great for detecting enemies, but field mics are absolutely king for this challenge. If you get one down in a good spot and you're able to keep it alive, that thing will help you farm this challenge so fast. This challenge is a relatively easy one to do, and you don't really need to focus on it too hard, because it's probably one that if you are using those score streaks and equipment, it's one that will just get done as you're leveling the gun up or whilst you're doing the other challenges like the 5 kill streaks. Again, a pretty easy camo challenge to do on the shotgun. So let's keep moving on to the science skins unlocked at level 25. and this is kill 75 enemies at point blank range in multiplayer. This challenge is definitely the most annoying of all the shotgun camo challenges, so it's not necessarily hard, like in terms of player skill. Obviously, the better you are, the easier the challenge is going to be. But it's not crazy hard. Like, Bloodthirsties, I understand why people struggle with that, because shotguns can be quite hard to use if you're not great with them. But point blank kills are just so annoying. And before I actually go through the advice for the point blank challenges, I do have a dedicated video which will be showing up in the top corner of your screen right now that shows you the absolute best methods for getting point blank kills on shotguns and SMGs. So if you want even more detail on this challenge, then feel free to go check out that video. I've had so much positive feedback about it, saying it massively helped people get more point blanks. Obviously, maybe I am a bit biased here because it is my video, but go check that one out if you need more help with point blanks. But anyway, in terms of just getting this challenge done, one of the first things you'll need to do is to make a quick adjustment to your class setup, and that is to change the stim shot to smoke grenades. And the reason for this is that you want to be using smoke grenades in order to get closer to your enemies much easier. So say you're playing Nuketown, you're able to smoke off one of the angles and push through it, or smoke it off and then flank around the back of it and then kill enemies from behind at point blank range. Smoke grenades are so useful for this challenge. If you want to go all in just focusing on this challenge, then maybe even swap the wild card to danger close, so then you get 2 smoke grenades in every life. That's completely up to you how hard you want to go for this challenge. I found generally 1 smoke grenade was fine, but if you really want to just smash out the point blank challenge, put on danger close and you'll have absolutely no problem getting up close and personal with your enemies. Another tip for getting point blanks much easier is basically you've got to be patient and really think about your positioning, whether it's the right time to come out of a good position and kill one enemy, or if you think there's going to be 3 more coming past you in just 5 seconds, just wait. Be patient. Then when they've run past you as well, if they haven't noticed you, you can just then step behind them, shoot each one in the back, job done. And yes, before you guys say it in the comments, this can depend on the lobby that you're in. If you're in a high level lobby, people are more likely to check those awkward corners or notice you, but I still stand by this tactic and it can work in absolutely any lobby. You just have to be smart about where you're positioning yourself and when the right time to strike is. I would definitely say that point blanks are my least favorite challenge for shotguns and SMGs. It's just so annoying to do, but hopefully my advice helps you get absolutely loads in each game. In fact, after this video, let me know what your best match was for getting as many point blanks as you can in one game. Anyway, let's move on to the final camo, which is Psychedelic, and this is my favorite camo challenge to do on any gun, just because it's a free pass to be like, okay, play like a madman, run into their spawn, run onto objectives, and just try and kill as many people as you can. So of course this challenge is to kill 2 or more enemies rapidly 25 times in multiplayer. In other words, get 25 double kills whilst using a shotgun. So again, this challenge can absolutely be done in core, it can absolutely be done in hardcore. You just choose whichever one you prefer. Wherever you're having the most fun, that's where you should be. This challenge itself is not particularly hard, but it is a great way to start off getting those 5 kill streaks. If you're able to get a double, triple, or even a quad kill with a shotgun, that is absolutely the best time to then be a bit more defensive, play smart like I said before, and play for that last kill or two in order to get that 5 kill streak. You're also pretty likely to get some progress towards this challenge whilst you're getting your point blanks, because you are going to be up close with enemies. It's going to be hectic trying to get those kills, so you are pretty likely to be getting some double kills mixed in there. Realistically, even though it is the last challenge you unlock, it's probably one of the easiest because you will just be getting these as you go along. And yeah, I mean, it is probably one of my favorite camo challenges because it's simple and it's fun. So I'd like to close out this video with basically an example strategy of how I would go about doing shotguns if I were to start again. So basically what I would do is I would play core in any of the playlists that I mentioned, so 6v6 face off, 12v12 mosh pit, and 24/7 Nuketown, and just play normally with the shotgun, have some fun, and level it up a bit. Whilst you're leveling the shotguns, double weapon XP is nice to use, but not really 100% necessary on the shotguns, because you do only have to level them up to level 30 in order to unlock all of the camo challenges. But if you've got tokens to burn, absolutely go for it. I've got so many tokens, I don't know what to do with them. And then once you hit level 15 and unlock the long shot challenges, I would then jump straight into hardcore and stay there until I get all of the long shots. Then once long shots are done, I'll then go straight back to core, because I do not want to be in hardcore any more than I have to be. And then basically just use the tips and tricks and advice that I've given in this video, so you can get those other camo challenges done nice and fast. And then there you go, that's your shotgun gold. Move on to the next one. One thing to note that not everyone actually knows about Cold War is that you don't have to do only the guns that are in the base game. So that means because you've only got to do 2 shotguns in order to get the diamond camo, you have a choice of any of the current shotguns there are. So at the minute there's 3 shotguns, the Hauer, the Gallo, and the Street Sweeper. If I were to choose just 2 shotguns to do, it would 100% be the Gallo and the Street Sweeper. They are both very strong shotguns, especially the Street Sweeper. That thing is busted. Honestly, I wouldn't bother with the Hauer at all unless you're going for like full completion of every gun. then fair enough. Aside from the point blanks and sometimes the 5 kill streaks, getting the shotgun's diamond is relatively easy and definitely really fun. I hope my advice helped you unlock these diamond shotguns nice and fast. If you enjoyed this video, I'd really appreciate it if you leave a like. It honestly helps the video so much. It helps more people see it, and that helps more people get this camo challenge done. If you have any further questions about any of the camo challenges, any weapons, maps, game modes, whatever, just ask away in the comments, I will respond to you. If you do enjoy my videos, please do go check out some of my other camo challenge guides. Again, I know I am a bit biased, but I honestly think my camo guides are the best, most factually correct out there on YouTube right now. So if you want to go be the judge of that, go check out the playlist and let me know what you think. I've had a lot of positive comments about my guides, and it really makes me happy that I am able to help people with these camo challenges. So feel free to go check out my camo challenge guides or any other content on my channel. There's absolutely loads there. If you don't know where to start, there'll be a load of cards shown on my end screen. So just go click one of them and enjoy yourself. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you had a good time here, and hopefully I'll see you again on my channel. Go get those shotguns diamond.